workplace environments are so diverse now, you know, across every which way, you know, I don't understand how it's allowed and tolerated. And so it came out. It's not what we were reading yesterday for sure. And, you know, to your point as well about whatever word you want to use, anxiety, anticipation, curious, you know, part of that was because of who was putting out the feelers and the notion of what was coming down the pike. And those were big NFL reporters. It wasn't just, you know, Tom Jones 17 on Twitter. I mean, it was names you're familiar with. And so when you hear that and you see that, you're like, wow, okay, something's happening today. And there, think about what was going on with the Redskins already for the past week with the name change. And so they've, something that they've defended over the years and they've basically been able to avoid was now unavoidable. And they are doing the right thing and they are changing the team name. And so you had that. And then on the heels of this, you start seeing those tweets and stories and you're waiting for the story to come out. So use whatever word you want. It came out not at 10:01, but more towards the latter stages of the afternoon. And we will see if Daniel Snyder is forced to sell this team based on these stories. You know, the names that came out, there are a couple of interesting ones because, you know, a few of them fired already. One retired, Larry Michael, mm-hmm. the radio announcer. We found out just promptly or abruptly is probably a better word, retired. And he, by all accounts, was in Snyder's quote-unquote inner circle, as the stories read. And also, I guess, his COO of the team, clearly working side-by-side with Daniel Snyder. So there are some big names in that article that with these allegations that, you know, I think were a little surprising to me for sure, but also surprising that Snyder's name was not. So I don't know where it goes from here. But that was the news yesterday that everybody was not expecting to hear, but was waiting to hear about. And so, you know, I don't know how you move on from this, but that's where we're at with the Redskins right now, or the Washington football team, whatever we're calling
it. It did make me think about that Dallas Mavericks story, because there was a lot of stuff that was going on in that organization that was bad and guys had to be fired. And Mark Cuban basically said, listen, I'm telling you the truth. I didn't know about any of this stuff. And then a lot of people said, well, that's hard to believe. You're the owner of the team. You're very involved. We see you in the stands. How did you not know about any of it? And he said, listen, you could believe me or not, but I don't know about any of it. And the difference between these two things and the fallout from it and what's going to happen is that, you know, Mark Cuban had delivered a championship to that franchise. And I hate to say that this stuff matters, but it does. He is a well-liked guy. And he is someone who has had a ton of success in other areas of his life. So when Mark Cuban says, I didn't know this was going on, I'm going to change this thing, this organization's going to look different, you believe him and you give him the benefit of the doubt, even though he's the owner of a franchise that was having this type of behavior happen under his nose. With Dan Snyder, there's no benefit of the doubt with him any longer. I don't think there's anybody that's going to say, you know, really, I can't believe that Dan Snyder was the owner of a team that had all these guys looking up the skirts of women while they're going up the staircase. Dan Snyder's team? Dan Snyder had guys working for him that were texting women who worked in the organization, I want to grab your ass? That can't be possible. I mean, Dan Snyder's such an upstanding individual. No, everybody's going to believe, hell yeah, that happened in that organization, because that guy is a bad guy. He is someone who clearly doesn't have control. He's hired a bunch of people that were running amok, and it's a toxic culture there. So everybody's going to end up believing every allegation, because this organization has just been that organization for the better part of, well, I guess, you know, however long he's owned it.
Yeah, I mean, they haven't had the best reputation. And you're right, I think it goes to the benefit of the doubt, track record, and all sorts of things like that. You know, the one thing with the Cuban situation and why I do believe him in a case like that is, you know, have you ever been around a certain place where when the boss is present, people act different? You know, sure. In a case like Mark Cuban, and if you, you know, look into his past and his history and his professional life, it's not Mavericks and Mavericks only. I mean, the guy has business after business after business. He travels a lot. I don't get the sense, and I don't know this. We would have to talk to people that cover the team in Dallas. I know he's at a lot of the games, if not all of them. I don't know how many he misses. But I know he's all over the world, essentially, with the private jet and tending to different things. My guess would be, it is possible that things like that could go on under your nose or, you know, without you being aware of, because you're just not simply there enough. And then when you are there, people are on their best behavior. When the ball, I mean, we see it here. You know, when Mark Chernoff walks through the newsroom, whether we're just talking fantasy baseball or whatever nonsensical stuff that's really not pertinent to the job we're supposed to be doing. If a kid's, if someone's in here being paid to cut tape, and instead he's flipping around watching Three's Company on TV on a Tuesday night, when Mark Chernoff walks through the newsroom, he's not doing that. I mean, it's just different. You all of a sudden, you know, your antennas are up. I better be on my best behavior. So I do agree that some guys can get the benefit of the doubt. And listen, once you can probably give him a pass as long as the track record and the history is good. With Daniel Snyder, there's a long list of things that those Redskin fans and football fans really don't like. So I agree with you that he's not the type of guy that's going to get a pass on something like this.
No, absolutely not. And what's really sad about this story, too, is, you know, you hear a couple of beat writers that are starting their career. Also, people that are in this organization, a couple of women who get hired. It was their dream to work in the NFL. Then they get thrown into this horrible environment. And then, you know, the one who was detailed the most, that her story was, you know, she's sobbing at her desk, doesn't want to work in pro sports any longer. I mean, that type of stuff, you know, me and you don't have to deal with. You know, when we got into sports, when we got into radio and WFAN and sports talk radio, we didn't have to deal with that type of stuff. I mean, yeah, you'd get some people that want to, when you're an intern, you can do certain things. You have to go pick up lunch or stuff like that, whatever. That's nothing. That type of stuff, when you're like going through the business, is nothing compared to what certain female employees have to put up with. And I couldn't even imagine that. Like, when I get hired for a dream job, but then all these pigs that are working in the office just care about what I'm wearing, how tight it is, and how they could catch me in a stairwell to get a glimpse of me. And that's all that I've been basically turned into in this office. It's not the job that I do. It's not the work that I do. It's not how I act around people. It's just how I look. I mean, that stuff is just... It's been going on for years and years and years, and finally we're getting to a point in this country where it's not going to be tolerated any longer, and it's not being tolerated any longer. So, you know, that part of the story to me is tough, because you think about, because we have worked at the place that we've always wanted to work. We always had a dream to work where we're working. So did these alleged victims in this story, and then they get there, and this is what happens to them. I mean, that's the type of stuff. I couldn't even imagine being in their shoes, to hearing some of the things that I, or reading some of the things I read yesterday.